Amen. Well, good morning, everyone. Our service of morning prayer, rite two, begins on page 78 of the Book of Common Prayer, or page two in your bulletin. Let the words of our mouths and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Let us now confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you. Forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen you in all goodness and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Lord, open our lips.
And our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Come, let us adore him.
The Venite may be found on page 82 in the Book of Common Prayer, or page 3 of your bulletin. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice.
The psalm appointed for today is Psalm 78, verses 1 through 7, which can be found in the Book of Common Prayer on page 694 or on pages 3 and 4 in the weekly bulletin. Hear my teaching, O my people.
Incline your ears to the word of my mouth.
I will open my mouth in a parable.
I will declare the mysteries of ancient times.
That which we have heard and known, and what our forefathers have told us.
We will not hide from their children.
We will recount to generations to come the praiseworthy deeds and the power of the Lord.
And the wonderful works he has done.
He gave his decrees to Jacob and established a law for Israel,
which he commanded them to teach their children,
that the generations to come might know, and the children yet unborn,
that they in their turn might tell it to their children,
so that they might put their trust in God
and not forget the deeds of God, but keep his commandments. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
A reading from Joshua. Joshua gathered all the tribes of Israel to Shechem, and summoned the elders, the heads, the judges, and the officers of Israel, and they presented themselves before God. And Joshua said to all the people, "Thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, long ago your ancestors, Terah and his sons, Abraham and Nahor, lived beyond the Euphrates and served other gods. Then I took your father Abraham from beyond the river and led him through all the land of Canaan and made his offspring many. Now therefore, revere the Lord and serve him in sincerity and faithfulness. Put away the gods that your ancestors served beyond the river and in Egypt and serve the Lord. Now, if you are unwilling to serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve, whether the gods your ancestors served in the region beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you are living. But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord." Then the people answered, "Far be it from us that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods. For it is the Lord our God who brought us and our ancestors up from the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, and who did those great signs in our sight. He protected us along all the way that we went, and among all the peoples through whom we passed. And the Lord drove out before us all the peoples, the Amorites, who lived in the land. Therefore, we will also serve the Lord, for he is our God." But Joshua said to the people, "You cannot serve the Lord, for he is a holy God. He is a jealous God. He will not forgive your transgressions or your sins. If you forsake the Lord and serve foreign gods, then he will turn and do you harm and consume you after having done you good. And the people said to Joshua, "No, we will serve the Lord." Then Joshua said to the people, "You are witnesses against yourselves that you have chosen the Lord to serve him." And they said, "We are witnesses." He said, "Then put away the foreign gods that are among you and incline your hearts to the Lord, the God of Israel." The people said to Joshua, "The Lord our God we will serve, and him we will obey." So Joshua made a covenant with the people that day and made statutes and ordinances for them at Shechem. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Canticle 9, the first song of Isaiah, is found on page 4 of the bulletin, or page 86 of the Book of Common Prayer. "Surely it is God who saves me. I will trust in him and not be afraid. For the Lord is my stronghold and my sure defense, and he will be my savior. Therefore, you shall draw water with rejoicing from the spring of salvation. And on that day, you shall say, 'Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make his deeds known among the peoples, so that they remember that his name is exalted. Sing the praises of the Lord for he has done great things, and this is known in all the world. Cry aloud, inhabitants of Zion, ring out your joy, for the great one in the midst of you is the Holy One of Israel.' Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was at the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen."
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Thessalonians, chapter 4, verses 13 to 18. Can you hear me?
Mm-hmm.
"We do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. For this we declare to you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will by no means precede those who have died. For the Lord himself, with a cry of command, with the archangel's call, and with the sound of God's trumpet, will descend from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. So we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This morning, we will read Canticle 19, the Song of the Redeemed. It's in the Book of Common Prayer on page 94 or page 5 of this bulletin. "O ruler of the universe, Lord God, great deeds are they that you have done, surpassing human understanding. Your ways are ways of righteousness and truth, O King of all the ages. Who can fail to do you homage, Lord, and sing the praises of your name? For you only are the Holy One. All nations will draw near and fall down before you, because your just and holy works have been revealed. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen."
Amen. Our third reading this morning comes from the Gospel of Matthew. Jesus said, "The kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. When the foolish took up their lamps, they took no oil with them, but the wise took flasks of oil with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, all of them became drowsy and slept. But at midnight, there was a shout. Look, here is the bridegroom. Come out to meet him. Then all those bridesmaids got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish said to the wise, give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out. But the wise replied, no, there will not be enough for you and for us. You had better go to the dealers and buy some for yourself. And while they went to buy it, the bridegroom came, and those who were ready went with him into the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later, the other bridesmaids came also, saying, Lord, open to us. But he replied, truly, I tell you, I do not know you. Keep awake, therefore, for you know neither the day nor the hour. The word of the Lord. From the prayer attributed to St. Francis that we'll read here shortly, Lord, make us instruments of your peace. In the name of our loving, liberating, and life-giving God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, union. By now, hopefully, you know the rest of that prayer. We've been saying it now for about 8 months in our morning prayer service. And it's been very intentional. And unfortunately, now it's probably even more prevalent and more needed than any other time. 8 months of saying this prayer, 8 months of walking together in this very interesting time of COVID and election time now and everything else. And now we have a projected winner of the president's race. We kind of know who might be our next president. There's still all the lawyers getting their arguments in order and everything. But the one thing that we do know in this time is that this country is so, so divided. And that just breaks my heart. And I think that's where this prayer of St. Francis comes in, even more so nowadays, because we have to be instruments of God's peace. We have to sow love where there is hatred, pardon where there is injury, and union where there is discord. I said this 4 years ago, and I'll say it again today. Some of my friends are crying with joy this day. Some of my friends are sad and upset. And I stand with my friends. As your priest, I want you to know that I am here with you and for you. And this congregation is probably a little microcosm of the world, if you will, or at least the United States, where we have people on both sides. Again, we have people that are just beaming with joy. I saw a post on Facebook just the other day from one of the priests here in Colorado, and a Black woman, and her daughter has a doll of Kamala and a doll of Obama, and they're playing, and they came out of the box. That's some of the joy that's being shared. And there's also worry in other parts of the state and in other parts of the country about what this election might mean. But for me, the worry is what this division means to a country that is supposed to be united. And how can we be part of that healing process? And that healing's not going to be heard, not going to happen over dueling flags and ever-increasing shouting across party lines, or differing sides yelling across the street. Now more than ever, we need to return to our baptismal covenant and this prayer attributed to St. Francis. We need to be instruments of God's peace. We are called as Christians in our baptism to seek and serve Christ in all people. We need to pray for those who might be seen as enemies. We need to know that we are loved, and we need to share that love. And we need to remember that it is God we serve, not a political party, not a candidate, but God. That's where our reading from Joshua comes into play for me this day. Joshua's words to the Israelites. Joshua asks the Israelites to choose this day who they will serve. The gods of their past, the gods of their ancient ancestors, or the God of Abraham. And of course, their thought and their conclusion is that they will serve God. And Joshua walks with them and kind of shares with them a little bit more what that looks like. But today, I think for us, for me at least, let me speak for myself. For me and my household, we will serve the Lord. We will do everything we can to walk with people, no matter where they are. Again, as your priest, I walk with you. And as your priest, I'm going to seek and serve Christ in all people. I'm going to look for that betterment in each one. I'm going to listen a little bit deeper, and I'll probably share a little bit more passionately about my understanding of the gospel. But it's in out of respect and in respect of those others, listening to them as much as I want to speak. So how do we go forward as a nation? How do we go forward as individuals? How do we go forward as Christians called to serve God, called to serve a loving, liberating, and life-giving God? Maybe it's to sit back for a moment, take a deep breath, and remember who it is we serve. As Bishop Carolyn Tanner Irish, I shared this just a couple weeks ago, as Bishop Carolyn Tanner Irish in Utah mentioned, we need to keep the main thing the main thing. And that main thing is the love of God shared for all of us who are flawed, all of us who are trying to figure out exactly where God is calling us to be. But knowing that God is calling us to walk together, to listen, to stand, and to be with those that we might disagree with, and to listen a little bit deeper. Loving God and loving our neighbor is primary in our lives as Christians. Loving God and loving our neighbor. Now more than ever, we need to build our relationships with God, make sure that as strong as it can be, but also build those relationships with our neighbor. As our gospel shares with us, we neither know the day nor the hour. And may we always be prepared. May we build that relationship with God in a new and stronger way. And may we reach out in love to our neighbors in new and stronger ways as well. So today, may we put the gods of our past away and choose this day to serve our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. And now we have our song of praise, and this one coming to us from Sharon Dinwell.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for everyone. Lord, we don't need another mountain.
Now the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Amen. I appeal to you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present yourselves as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
You.
Let us pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. We continue with suffrages A, found on page 97 of the Book of Common Prayer, if you're following there. Show us your mercy, O Lord.
And grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving health among the nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
And the collect for this Sunday. O God, whose blessed Son came into the world that he might destroy the works of the devil and make us children of God and heirs of eternal life. Grant that having this hope, we may purify ourselves as he is pure, that when he comes again with power and great glory, we may be made like him in his eternal and glorious kingdom, where he lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. And a prayer for times of conflict. O God, you have bound us together in a common life. Help us in the midst of our struggles for justice and truth to confront one another without hatred or bitterness and to work together with mutual forbearance and respect through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And a prayer for the whole human family. O God, you made us in your own image and redeemed us through Jesus, your Son. Look with compassion on the whole human family. Take away the arrogance and hatred which infect our hearts. Break down the walls that separate us. Unite us in bonds of love and work through our struggle and confusion to accomplish your purposes on earth, that in your good time, all nations and races may serve you in harmony around your heavenly throne, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The prayer attributed to Saint Francis. This may be found in the Book of Common Prayer on page 833 or page 8 in your bulletin. Lord, make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, union. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen.
Chris, you're muted.
Doing it again. I hit the wrong key. Unmuted now?
Yes.
You good?
Cool. The prayers of the people, form three, may be found on page 387 of the Book of Common Prayer or page 9 of your order of service. Father, Mother, Creator of all, we pray for your Holy Catholic Church.
That we may all be one.
Grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for Bishop Kim, for all bishops, priests, deacons, and lay ministers.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to the departed eternal rest.
That light perpetual shine upon them.
Today we lift up all those we know and love, but see no longer. We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
That we may also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
Let us pray for our own needs and those of others. Today, Lord, we pray for all those in our parish family who are sick, those who care for them, and those who are in need of God's strength and guidance. For Chris, Jarrett Hardin, Emily Fuller, Dennis Lane, Laura Jenkins and family, Peggy, Macy, Susan and Patrick Malone, Sandy Z, Jay, Christy, Baby Violet, Debbie, Nancy Z, Dan B, Irene, Susie R, Sarah P, Carrie, Arlene, Derek, Megan, and the Koltiska family, Debbie and Dave and family, Freddie, Michael L., Jen and family, Martha, Dave and Judy, Jane and family, Kim W. and family, our military families, law enforcement and first responders, our homebound parishioners and those in nursing facilities. Today, we pray for all those affected by the coronavirus. Those who have died, those who are sick, those in quarantine, and their families. We pray for the firefighters and all affected by the forest fires in Colorado in the West. We pray for rain and relief from the drought. And today we especially pray for our country in this divided time and after the elections. We pray for justice. We pray for peace. We pray for understanding. And we pray for an end of the racism and hate that continues to infect and divide this country. We celebrate with those who have birthdays this week: Christopher Reed, Trevor Hart, Alexandra Sroki, Mick Steffen, and Wayne Smolt, as well as with those celebrating anniversaries: Brett James and Sarah Punzo James, Eric Zelt, and Melissa Ball.
Holy and gracious God, we do lift these and all the prayers of our hearts up to you, knowing that you are constantly doing more than we could ever ask or imagine. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
God's peace, everyone. Good to have everyone here with us. Just a few quick announcements. Actually, for this time of peace, since we're all back on Zoom, I invite you to reach out, to either text someone or give them a call and share Christ's peace with them in this time also. We are obviously back online solely, and we'll probably be online for at least another week. And actually the weeks after that, I'm hoping we might be able to move into the sanctuary with a few people and record from, or do the Zoom from there. And that way have Eucharist. But for these next 2 weeks at least, even I will be at home on Zoom with you. So please pray, and pray for all those with coronavirus, and pray for our state and our country as we try to keep those numbers down. Today is our in-gathering, if you will, for our pledge cards. So we're hoping to have all of those in today, or at least by tomorrow. And so our treasurers can get working on the budget. So if you've, we've got quite a few in. So thank you for those who have sent them in. If you haven't received one or haven't gotten them in, you can find them on our website, along with some great videos of our ministry minutes and everything. But our whole package, stewardship package, is online as well. The Alive magazine is out and emailed, and we have the electronic edition as well as the paper edition, if you will. If you would like a printed copy, let either myself or Ash know, and we can make sure there's one available outside of the church office door and everything for you in these times. But there's a great new plugin online, so you can just flip through it like a regular magazine online. So check it out. Some great stories in there. We also are feeding over at Oakwood for Thanksgiving here, I believe next week. And so if you are willing to help and able to help with that, please see Barb Nickel. We will be cooking from home and then bringing it together in the gap with a limited number of people in there with all the precautions. We'll put them in the dishes and all that, and then we'll take them over and deliver from there. So if you can help out, please reach out to Barb. Also, starting this Thursday, we're going to start up our online coffee house hours once again. So from 4:30 to 6, I'll be on Zoom for that hour and a half, and just ready to talk to you and whatever you might want to visit about, and just kind of check in. So again, Thursdays from 4:30 to 6, I'll be on Zoom. Obviously not Thanksgiving Day, but other than that, we'll get that started. And we also are looking for a wonderful Advent study time to coming as well. So look forward to some announcements on that. And Trevor, did you want to do any announcement as far as online readers during this time we're back on Zoom?
Oh, thank you. Yeah, please. If you are interested in reading on one of the Zoom morning prayers, please let me know. Particularly, I'm just kind of going with my faithful readers, and I'd love to expand that universe. So please let me know that you're interested in reading. And then also, if for a particular week you cannot make it, let me know. That would be helpful. But thank you for your faithfulness in doing these readings.
Yes, it's great to hear everyone's voices. All right. And if you have any other announcements, please email those either to myself or to Ash, and we'll make sure that those get in our weekly emails. And now we continue with the general Thanksgiving.
The general Thanksgiving can be found on the Book of Common Prayer on page 101 or on page 10 of your bulletin. Please join me. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, We, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love and the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts, we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen.
Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Be careful as you go out into God's creation, for it does not belong to you. Be gentle with yourself and with one another, for you are the dwelling place of the Most High God. Be alert and hesitant, for sometimes God is but a whisper. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you this day and always. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Great to see everyone.